Hello again, everyone. Welcome to CAAPID Simplified. I hope you liked our previous videos. Feel free to email us if you want to know more about anything we talked about. Today, I'm going to talk about TOEFL, Test of English as a Foreign Language. So, TOEFL is a mandatory requirement to apply to dental schools and to do anything in the United States for that matter. So TOEFL basically has four sections. That would be reading, listening, speaking, and writing. And each of these sections is scored out of 30. So what would you say is a good score? A good score is anything that's above 100. And you don't just look at the score as a whole, but what do dental schools look for? And dental schools look for what's your score in listening and speaking, because that's the most important in communication, right? And as dentists, we have to be very good at communication, and that's what they look for. So your score in listening and speaking, and for any other section for that matter, if it's above 23 or equal to 23, then that's a fair score. But if it's about 25 or equal to 25, that's a good score, and that's what you're aiming for. And generally, your TOEFL scores are valid for 2 years. Make sure that you look at each program's requirement of how long the scores have to be valid. I say this because you might be able to avoid problems in the future. Some schools expect that your scores should be valid till the point of application. Some schools expect that your scores must be valid until the time you matriculate. Now, when I say matriculate, I mean when you start the program. So make sure that you look at that before you apply for the program. And if you have to retake, please do retake. Now, I also wanted to touch up on what TOEFL has brought in recently from August 2019, which works out really well for us, which is called My Best Score. So what TOEFL does is, it takes your scores, but only within the span of the last 2 years. Remember I said your TOEFL scores are only valid for 2 years. So it takes all scores that you got from the test that you took in the past 2 years, and it shows you what your best score was. So basically your school will be able to see the score from your most recent test and also your best score, which is good because it shows that you can do well. Another thing that I wanted to talk to you about with the recent happenings with COVID-19 is the special home edition of TOEFL. So the special home edition of TOEFL was introduced from 23rd March 2020, and it's only available in certain countries. So I just wanted to tell you which countries there are. So it's in the United States, Canada, Colombia, France, Germany, Italy, Spain, Hong Kong and Macau in China. So these are the countries where it has been given, and it's a test that you can take at home in your own computer. They have certain requirements that you have to fulfill, and it will be monitored by a human proctor online. It's a great thing that's happening right now, but it's not valid in certain other countries. So please be up to date. If they're adding your country to the list, then you would be able to take it online in your own house, which is great, right? And lastly, I also want to talk to you about what happens if you have a low TOEFL score, or what happens if you have multiple attempts in TOEFL. Is that a bad thing in admissions? I wanted to talk to you about that because a lot of students asked me if that's a bad thing. Firstly, about low TOEFL score, I would recommend that you retake the exam and make sure that you have a good score, something touching 100 or above 100, because it's always a good requirement and it just puts you ahead of a lot. Now, if you have multiple attempts in TOEFL and each attempt shows some progress in your TOEFL score, it's a good thing. And as far as what I understood from talking to faculty in dental schools and people from the admissions committee, from students, this is what I know from my understanding, which is they like your perseverance. They like that you're trying. They like that you're getting better. So it just shows that you really want to do this. So don't take that as something that's negative on your part, it's not. And when you do get that good score, go ahead and apply, and it'll all be well. So if you have any questions about TOEFL or anything that we talked about in this video, please feel free to reach out to me. And if you do want us to talk about something else, shoot an email to us and we'd be happy to talk about it. Have a nice day.